Nigeria is blessed with abundant, viable land and water resources, and the country's agricultural sector has a high potential for yield. But this potential is far from being realized. Before the discovery of the crude oil, agriculture is said to be the most viable sector of the nation's economy, providing employment to the vast majority. However, it appears that since the discovery of crude oil, the agricultural sector has been relegated to the background. On the heels of this, some members of the public have started charting a roadway for the incoming government at the federal level in the area of agriculture. Some respondents enjoined government to invest more in agriculture in order to discourage the importation of food items. They said the viability of the agricultural sector will not only make the country self-sufficient, it will also create jobs for the teeming unemployed.
I remember those days that we used to have an agriculture, you see people doing groundnut, doing cocoa, for him to empower those on the rural area so that they'll be able to go into farming and at the same time assist their family, because that is the only way that we can grow.
Agriculture, it will create more employment to the youths. Even myself, everybody should go back to farming. By way of importing to our country, it's not the best option for this country. We know in the olds, when we used to go to the farm, food is surplus. OFN in those days, we know what it is. Ekpoma rice in those days, we knew to farm. I'm from Esa Central. We do go to farm in that time, but Ekpoma rice is no more in existence.
Youth should be encouraged, maybe giving funds to go into agricultural activities, not just to depend on white collar jobs. There are a lot of persons who have studied agricultural courses who are not making use of them today. I think those areas need to be looked at, so that if there are ways the government can empower them and help them to go back to agriculture, at least to boost the economy, that would be very, very fun.
Some farmers speak on the gains of farming and appeal to the federal government to support farmers.
In those days, cocoa was one of the cash crops. Before the oil, we talked about cocoa and groundnut. But this is cocoa now, 2 years, it's tough footing from screen in Ibadan. With this, it will help the government. To improve agriculture. Other than the 2 years, when you harvest cocoa, you know what it gives you. You get bags of cocoa.
With the citrus alone, you can make more money. Then students, those who have no job, will be able to get job when you go on citrus. We did onboarding. We do grafting. We do mark cutting on the citrus. So that's how we make it. If the federal government happen to put money in agriculture in Nigeria, we get more money.
Speaking on how the agricultural sector can be developed in Nigeria, the program manager, Edo State Agricultural Development Program, Mr. Paul Isiahia, said the federal government should encourage small and large-scale farmers through provision of loans. He said modern-day techniques should be employed by research institutes to help improve the agricultural sector.
In the sixth geopolitical zone of this country, you have several research institutes, even more than two in some zones, you know, ensuring that technologies are bound on the shelf. The ADP zeroed or focused on small-scale farmers, you know, because we know that they are the ones that really put food on our table, and extending all these research findings to them so that they can get these technologies to do well in agriculture.
Nigeria was in the forefront of agriculture in Africa in the late 70s before attention was shifted to crude oil. Best Mbiere reporting.